Hello students, today in this video I'll teach you how to use file tab of MS Word. Okay, so before that we have to start MS Word. So I think in my previous video I have already given the demo how you can open MS Word. Okay, so I'm using the simplest way, using this desktop icon. I have to double click on this. By this my MS Word will open. Okay, now these are the tabs: file, home, insert, page layout, reference, mailings, review and view. In this video I am talking about this file tab, the first tab, and you can say the most important tab for your work. Okay, so before that I need some text on this page, so I am showing you one command. By this you can type three paragraphs automatically by writing just one word. The command is equal to RAND. Press the shift key from your keyboard and then press 9 and 0 button to apply the brackets. Okay, after this press the enter key and you will see that three paragraphs are in front of you. Okay, so it will not take much time to write the text. By using this command you can get three tabs. Okay, now look at the document name. The name of the currently open document. Whenever you open MS Word, by default its name will be document 1, 2, 3, like this. Okay, so after you give the name, any name according to your need or your choice, then this will change. Okay, so basically you can say file menu will help you to save as, open, close, these things. Okay, so first thing, most important thing, save. If you want to save your data for future use, you must know this. Okay, so currently my document name is document 1. Now I want to save it with my name, so I have to click on this save, and shortcut key is Control plus S. If you press the Control plus S key, look, I'm here. If I press the Control plus S key, I'll get this dialog box in front of me, this one. This is a dialog box of save. Okay, and you can do it by this file, click on save. Okay, that is your choice. Now here I have to give the name, file name, any name you can give according to your choice. I am giving Sam. Okay, now from this list you can decide where you want to save this file. For my convenience I am showing it on, or I am saving it on desktop. Okay, you can save it in computer, C drive, D drive, anywhere. Okay, suppose, okay, look, I am showing you how to make new folder with your name and how to save this file in that folder. Okay, so I am making new folder in the D drive. Okay, in D drive I have to click here, new folder, look, and you will get this icon. Now you can give any name. I am giving the name Samir. Okay, now press enter twice. Look, your Samir folder is opened. Now you can save your file with Sam and click on save. Okay, now look here, before saving the file it was document 1. Now I have given some name, that's why the name is here, Sam. Okay, this is the way by which you can save your file. Okay, now look, I am closing it. Now if you say, sir, I want to open that file. Okay, there are two ways. First, open MS Word from here again. Go to this file tab, click on open. Now where we have saved the file, in D drive. So you have to move down, select the D drive here. Now folder name was Samir. Look, Samir is here. Open this folder. Look, this is your file. Now double click on this and your file will open. So by this we have talked about two things: save and open. How to save file and how to open your file. Okay, now if you want to change the name of this file, and if you want to save this file at any other location, then we can use save as. Look, they both are same, nearly same. They both are used to save the file. But save as, first of all, the save will save the fresh file for you. And if you want to save that file again, save that file again with the, you can say, different name and different location, you have to use save as. Okay, so I'm clicking on save as. You will get the same dialog box. Now here you can select, I'm selecting desktop. I want to save this file with name RAM. Okay, and on desktop. Okay, now look, first of all, look at the name RAM. Okay, now I'm closing it. Look here, this is your file with the name RAM. That means same file with different names we have saved. Okay, now you can open it directly from here also using your double click. Okay, this is the way by which you can use save, save as, and open. Okay, now next one is close. If you want to close your file, close means if you want to close this file only. We don't want to close the whole software. If you want to close the whole software, we have this option, exit. But right now I want to just close the file, so I have to use this close option. As I do this, look, now we have nothing opened in front of us. This is the way by which you can save your file, save as, open, close. Okay, again I'm opening it. You can open it from here. Okay, next one is info. Now this is not useful for you. Info will help you in giving the permissions. If you want to apply any password or anything in your file, you can do it by using this one. We will talk about this later. This is not important for you. Next one is recent. Recent will help you to open the recently used file. Look, if you suppose you have used your file 2 or 3 days back, so you don't need to go to this. You can use the recent feature, and in this list you will get all the files. You have to just click on, suppose look, currently my RAM file is opened. If you want to open SAM file, just click here, your SAM file will open. Look, okay, now both are opened. From here you can check RAM and SAM, dono files open hai apne samne. Okay, next one is new. If you want to create blank new document, so you have to click on this, click on this blank document and click on create. So you will get a new fresh document with the name document one. Okay, next one is print. If you want to take out the printout of your file, look, I am opening again this one, RAM, SAM. Now click on file, click on print. If you want to take out the printout of this page, it will look like this. So you can just click on this and you have to select the printer from here. Which printer you have currently installed in your PC will be displayed here. I don't have any printer right now. That's why I'm not getting any. So if you have printer, just select the number of copies and click on print. And about these, we will talk about these later whenever I teach this page layout and in this. Okay, next, save and send. If you want to directly send this file to any of the email as PDF, and for that we use this. Right now we are not using it, it's not important for you. Next one is help. If you want to take out the help about any of the feature of your this MS Word, you can go here. Options will help you to do the settings of this. If you want to change the settings of your this MS Word document, you can go here, but it is not advised. That is for the administrator. Okay, so you don't have to touch it. Last, exit, I already told you. If you want to go out of the software, we will use exit. Okay, the difference between close and exit is close will help you to close the currently opened file, and exit will move you out of the software. Look, here I am. Okay, so that's it for today. In the next video, we will talk about the home tab. Okay, if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel and share my videos so that others also take help out of them. Okay, thank you.